again from Young Nation. Tonight, as promised last week, Anna, Björn, Benny and Annifrid, known collectively as ABBA. They're in Britain to launch their new album called Arrival and their new single, Money, 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 both in the shops this week. ABBA, now one of the most successful groups in the world since they won the Eurovision Song Contest 2.5 years ago with Waterloo. Waterloo, I was defeated, you won the war. Waterloo, which became a number one hit in Britain and all over Europe, selling over 5 million records. Many winners of the Eurovision Song Contest are one-hit wonders, but ABBA have gone from strength to strength.
It all started a long time ago. The youngest in the group, 26-year-old Anna, was a singer with a dance orchestra until she had a solo hit of her own with a song she wrote herself. Björn, now her husband, used to be a banjo and guitar player with a Dixieland band. He then became the leader of a country rock group called the Hootenanny Singers. In 1966, he met Benny, who was then touring with Hep Stars, the most popular Swedish band of the 60s, and they teamed up to write songs. Anna Fried, Frida for short, started singing when she was 10. She sang with an orchestra for some years before joining a popular television show in 67. And 2 years later, in 1969, Björn and Benny met the girls. As a foursome, they are now one of the most popular groups in the world, in spite of the fact that they hardly ever leave Sweden. When they arrived in London on Monday, Young Nation was there to meet them. I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay. Ain't it sad? And still there never seems to be a single penny left for me. That's too bad. ABBA, cool, glamorous, relaxed, a suave Swedish foursome. If I got me a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work at all. I'd fool around and have a ball. They can afford to be, with 3 best-selling albums and 8 singles in the last 2.5 years. Money, money, money. With songs like Fernando, Mamma Mia, Dancing Queen, and now Money, 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 their currency holds good. You're squashed here into the back of a limousine. You look like sardines. Are you comfy, first of all?
Well, it's all right, yeah.
Do you like travelling?
Car, yes.
Well, what about that helicopter? Were you nervous?
I was. I don't like it.
It's very shaky about flying. You know?
Yeah.
Do you like London? Because this isn't your first visit. You've been here quite a lot.
Yes, we love it. We love it. It's a great city. And the people here are very nice.
Yeah. And the beer.
You're the happy couple. Now,
no, we are.
Are we?
You're about,
we are just engaged.
You're
you know,
engaged,
so that's why.
All the things I could do. If I had a little money, it's a rich man's world. It's a rich man's world. suffice to say, they're all happy. A Scandinavian group who's now international. Now, has Sweden said, thank you very much, you've made us some money?
No, not that, but the audience, they say thank you by, I mean, they write letters to us and they buy our records and they seem to like the music very much.
And what about the royal family? Have you met them?
Not actually met
them. We haven't said hello to them, but we performed Dancing Queen for them the night before they got married.
And it went down well?
Oh, yes, extremely well.
Girls, the boys do the writing. What about the cooking? Do they ever help you backstage in the kitchen?
Oh, yes, very often. We kind of share it, you know.
Yeah, we do too. It's kind of a hobby with me, actually.
What have you been
cooking? Whether Anna likes it or not, I don't know.
Anna?
I like your food.
You do?
I know that. Mm-hmm.
That's fine. Now, you've been in London. You've also been in the States recently. Did you manage to hit America as well as you've hit Europe?
It haven't actually started there yet, but I think it will come sooner or later.
Do you think it's a difficult market to conquer?
It is.
Of course.
It's so large, you know, it's a continent, it's not a country.
It takes time.
I think we've promoted ourselves in Europe, Australia and everywhere else, mainly by television. And television doesn't mean that much in the States. You have to tour, I think.
Somebody said you've exploited television. Other groups are unhappy, they're there performing. They're uneasy out of the recording studio. Do you enjoy television?
You have to ask the girls, they're the faces.
There's a knack of looking good, and I think you've managed to find it. Do you think it's the reason why you're so successful?
It's very hard to say.
I think it's a song, actually. That are the most important thing.
Do you get help when you do your stage routine? Are you directed by someone?
Yeah, we have a choreographer that helps us, but we try not to do it. Vad heter det? Schematiskt.
Not too elaborate.
No.
Well, another reason, of course, is your songs. They're very hummable. They're very happy-go-lucky. Now, can you tell us about these? How do you write them?
Very hard to describe, actually.
Do you do it at home? Do you work office hours all day long?
Yes, sort of.
Yeah. And we do most of our writing in the summer, because we have our summer resorts outside in a small island outside Stockholm. And we all go there during, well, 3 or 4 months over the summer, and we have the peace to write, you know.
We decide that now we're going to write. We meet 10 o'clock, even 9 sometimes. And we sit down by the piano and the guitar, and we sort of play around a little, and if we're lucky, something comes up.
Well, let's see if we're lucky today, if that's all right with you.
Yeah.
We've got a piano, we've got a guitar. Can we put you there and
maybe
ask you to be
you
creative?
A little idea. It's
yes,
very
that
hard.
Would be interesting.
It's very difficult to do.
Right. Björn and Benny, excuse us for a moment.
Sort of. I mean, if I play, we'll meet again, and Björn can play the theme from the Flintstones, and out comes Fernando, you know.
Well, let's hear it.
But it's roughly we decide on a rhythm and a key.
Like just starting playing anything. Very simple chords, or
this side goes on, and maybe
might come, you know.
That comes up,
we just stop, you know.
Yeah,
when we hear something coming
and
that we like,
you both stop at the same time.
Well, normally we do, because we feel about the same about
that's
our music
about it. We feel that this is something,
and that's what we're looking for all the time. I mean, trying to please ourselves and trying to find real good melodies, good lines.
Yeah,
the words always come second.
Yes, sometimes they come at the same time, but usually second.
Yeah.
Do you think you're calculating in the way you compose a song?
No. Not at all.
It's
I'd say the reason it takes so long time for us is that you really don't know what you like until you hear it. I mean, if you hear a good song, you hear a good song, and you can't tell exactly it's because it goes like that or so, you know?
It's very
impossible to say, so you really have to sit down for hours and hours and
all of a sudden something comes up. And of course it helps when we're two people working.
It's nice to be able to show it like this, because it is very, very irrational. And it's just from inside. And it's never speculated. Which means that it takes, as Benny says, it takes a long time and it's very hard.
Well, neither of you have had a classical music background. No. Do you not look at songs that have worked commercially and think, that's a rift that will make us a lot of money?
No. You mean pick from... No,
never.
Then we might as well quit.
But anyway, it doesn't work that way. Anyone who thinks that would work is mistaken.
I could guess. I mean, we don't write or read music, so we have to store it in the back of our heads since, I mean, we're 30 years old. And during 30 years, you hear a lot of music. So it could be that sometimes something is similar to something else. But, I mean, we don't know about it while we do it. Maybe somebody can come a year later and say, hey, those two lines there is like that song from Western Germany in 1942.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, you said you were 30. What about 30 years on? Do you think you'll still be going into your music studio with the piano and the guitar and writing?
if we enjoy it like we do now, I think we'll continue as long as we like it.
I don't think you'll see ABBA 60 years old.
No, probably not.
Are you sure?
I'm not sure, no.
But we could hope. We could hope that maybe one song that we made during the years will last, even if ABBA doesn't last.
Yeah.
Here's hoping. Good luck and bon voyage with the return trip.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.